experience of what it's like, what people on YouTube ask from you, you know. They want certain qualities in movies, or else why still just flame you, you know. I just make my videos the way that people can, you know, get amused by them, you know. I try my best making proper videos, and like you say, if older or higher experienced players in the game watch my movies and might say bad things about it, well, if you know, there are older players than me, but I you know, older people in WoW, you know, like people of 30 or an age of that, and movie makers of age 30 and age like that, they can get along with me pretty well, because my English, it's all right. If you know, if you ask people on Skype, you know, and I'm just having a conversation with them, it's like, they always go like, wow, dude, you talk the same as some few New Yorker dudes, and no, you know. So, you know, age isn't really that much of a difference, that much of an obstacle, that's a better word for it. You know, if they say bad things about, you know, about my movies, usually people of higher age are grown up and mature and can go like, well, if I don't like this movie, I won't say anything about it, because it's just not worth my time, you know. If you're older, you'll realize that it's better to spend your time elsewhere if you're not going to spend it useful, you know. So I'm not scared about what other people might say about my videos, especially older people. I mean, I can get along with older, you know, older people. I prefer playing with people of, let's say, 30 or 20, instead of playing with people of like 12 or something, simply because I don't like the freaking drama that young people bring with them. It's really childish, and I don't like that. So, yeah, nice question, Mr. Narf. I'll continue now. Adol PHGLG1, I like your name, dude. Ask one, why do you rule a shaman? Two, do you have any alliance jars? Three, how long have you been playing WoW? Four, do you plan on making plans for videos in the future? Five, I love you, have my babies, please, don't know how. Why do you roll a shaman? Well, I just repicked, you know, when I started Bloodfood, I just repicked World of Warcraft, and me and my buddy were like, let's level together, you know. And he was like, well, what's the fastest class to level? I was like, you know, I wanted a druid. So I told him, you know, shaman is the best leveling class. And he was like, oh, alright. So he made a shaman. And he was like, you're gonna make a shaman too, right? And I was like, ah, you know, screw it, I'll make a shaman. So I leveled that shaman. And I really liked the shaman. I mean, it's an awesome class. And, you know, when I was leveling through it, it was like, wow, I really like this class. You know, I like every single aspect of it. And so when I reached level 20, I was like, oh man, I want to share this with the world, you know. So then I started making leveling series, and shaman is just a very amusing class. Great for leveling, great for soloing, great for healing as well. Pretty easy healing, but it's amusing, you know. Do you have any alliance charters? Like I just told you, like I just said, I have my Knight of Druid right now. And the most important, I had a human paladin on which I used to play. Really had great times with him. But you know, sometimes World of Warcraft just became too boring, so I quitted him, and then I returned with my shaman. How long have you been playing WoW? For probably just after Burning Crusade came out, so don't know what it is in years anymore. I forgot, sorry. But seriously, playing at the start of Web of the Lich King, I played like once in a while on a non-updated Burning Crusade account before, just after Burning Crusade came out. So that's how long. Do you have plans for videos in the future? Like I said, Machinima probably, and of course my new, you know, guides, not gold making guides. I'm not very keen on them. I find gold not that. I'll just discuss that in another video, or this will get too long. This will probably be a 2-part or 3-part video. So, yeah, I love you. Have my babies, please. Don't know how. Well, you know, if you want my babies, you'll either have to be A, a very hot chick, or B, you'll need to pay me a few $100,000 million. So yeah, because your babies will probably be pretty tall, so that's a good thing. And they'll have, well, whatever. If you don't know how to get babies, just Google it. It's pretty useful to Google it. TJ3Enzo asks, I have three questions to ask. Ah, nice, three questions to ask. Amazing. What server do you play on, and do you play EU or US? Will you make any PvP videos? What classes have you played on WoW? What's your favorite class? Three questions to... Alright, what server do you play and do you play AU? I play European WoW and I play the Nordrasil server. Yeah, the Nordrasil server. Great server for Horde. Go check it out. Will make any PvP videos. Just to tell you, Shaman is very boring at PvPing unless you're elemental. And even then it's very boring. So it's not... you know, PvP worthy videos, but if I have another level 80, I'll probably make PvP videos because it's a dream of mine, you know. What classes have you played in WoW? What's your favorite class? I've played a Paladin, Druid, Warlock. Let's see, Warlock. Of course, my Shaman. What else did I get to 60? Come on, I did recruit friend. Warlock, Druid. Warlock Druid. Also, I have a warrior for level 60. The guys never saw him, unfortunately. Yeah, I'm gonna find it out, you know. I got it somewhere here, down here. Let's say rough. Leveling a druid, leveling a warlock. Well, and a mage. Oh yeah, I'm a mage. Ha ha ha. I have a mage. I have a warlock. I have a druid. I have a paladin. I have a warrior. I have a shaman. Favorite class, Shaman, probably, because it's a very easy class and you can still have a lot of fun with it. What's your gear score? What do you feel about the way gear score is abused? Of course, my gear score is 5.4k, like I just said. And what do you feel about the way gear score is abused? Well, if you, like me, get proper gear score, you don't care about it anymore, you know. If you got proper gear, you're like, well, let people cry about bad gear score, I don't care about it anymore, you know. But I had a period where gear score was just overhyped and was turning me down on raids. I find gear score one of the worst add-ons ever created. I don't like it being abused, like you just said. It's really being abused. It's overused. I mean, you know, gear score for me, it is a good indicator. If somebody has less than 5k gear score, you know, he shouldn't be entering Ice Crown, to be honest, unless he would be doing the first four bosses, you know. In some aspects gear score is good, but it's being abused. I find skill more important. But yeah, let's say if somebody's 3k gear score, somehow he shouldn't be entering Ice Crown. So somehow gear score is good in a way. And people probably agree with me on that matter. Fair Matt. Oh, by the way, the guy who asked me the question's name is Moncal Wow Production. Moncala Wow Productions. Yeah. Fair Matt asks, what do you think about Cataclysm, and what will you roll? I think it's amazing. Like you saw, I went into the alpha. I checked a lot of stuff out. My intentions were rolling a Worgen Druid, but I already have Night Elf Druid right now, so probably not. Probably something Goblin Priest, Shadow Priest, you know, Shadow Form and Goblin, and the card will probably look pretty great. Cataclysm overall will be a good expansion. I don't like the stat changes, of course, and some things are just bad that they did, but, you know, there are better things that are going to happen, you know. So Cataclysm is an okay expansion, but I shouldn't be making opinions about it right now if it isn't barely